Which obstruct the Nirodha Samadhi or distract the Dhyayi from accomplishing the Asampradnyata or Nirodha Samadhi are being described in the case of Uddaka. So he started seeing many things in terms of mental images. Any mental image is a product of the mind, and therefore it is what else? In the realm of Adhyastha Jagat, Anatma, the realm of Adhyastha, it cannot be Atma Swarupa. Atma Swarupa is totally free from Adhyastha Prapancha. Mind is Adhyastha or not? If you give up mind, what will happen? Shanti, Shanti, Shanti. But you can't give up just like that unless the Ajnana is totally destroyed. So they say, the last one we have seen, that Vivekarka Stamachannaha. The Viveka discrimination was likened to a sun which is covered by darkness, the tamas, the darkness of ignorance, for which an illustration was given, like that darkness is like what? Like as black as collyrium. In the Ramakrishna Mission book, the translation is given because Hridayambara is there, no? Hridayakasha. So the Akasha sun is there. Sun gets covered by clouds. So therefore that Lola Kajjala Mechakam is given as by dark blue clouds. That's a figurative expression also. Continuing. Tadapi or tamapi tam, that ajnanam api samyak jnana vivasata vivasvata utsadayamasa. Utsadayamasa, uprooted, destroyed that ignorance also which was covering the viveka by samyak jnana vivasata, by proper discrimination. Means he could get rid of that that covering in terms of ignorance. So that is samyak jnana means vivasvan. Vivasvan is sun. The samyak jnana compared to vivasvan, by that he removed that. Svante tamasi uparate, when the darkness was uparate, when it ceased to be there, saha udalakaha, that udalaka teja punjam dadarsha, he saw bright and brilliant light. You would have been happy, no? I saw light. In meditation, do you know? I saw light. You saw light means what? You are not meditating, that's all. Saha teja punjam dadarsha. So he did tallulava na dadarsha. Then what he did? Tat balaha dipaha sthalabdhyanam iva lulava. Even that, what is that? Teja punjam lulava, he destroyed. How? like Balaha Dvipaha. You know, Dvipaha is elephant. Balaha Dvipaha, young elephant. Young elephant, how it destroys the forest of Sthalabjanam Vanam. Sthalabjanam. Sthalabja, Vanam is a forest. What is Sthalabja? Abja is lotus. Now, land lotus, what is that land lotus? Flower. Hibiscus. It is hibiscus. Dasara, they say dasara. Shoe flower? Is shoe flower it is called? Really? What it has to do with that hibiscus and Dasara. Shoe flower. First time I So anyway, the hibiscus. A red hibiscus, etc. No, it is a cluster. No, there is like a... It is not, that's why the Baladvipa, young elephant, means how easily it destroys that way, he destroyed that, means he got rid of that vision, that's all. He got rid of that vision of seeing the light. If he didn't know the goal, he would have enjoyed, bright light I am seeing. Baladvipa, Lablava, he destroyed. Now, what has happened? The darkness went, now the light went, then what happened? Let us see. Tejasi uparate, that bright light he got rid of. What it up means? There was no light. It was in terms of a mental image, and he got rid of that image. So that when it went, see, tasya munehe ghurnamanam manaha, the mind which began to reel, whirl, the mind began to whirl, reel as ghurnamanam manaha. Ghurnamanam means that which was reeling, so that which was whirling, manaha. So what happened, that mind? Again, Nishabdavat Nidram Aga. It slept. Nidram Aga is slept. How? Nishabdavat, like the abda, like the lotus is in the night. What happens to the lotus in the night? They get closed. So like that, so he slept. Like you sleep in the class. Because he gets rid of it, means to be, he was aware of, that means drowsiness, etc. He was aware of it. So that, or he, after some time, he said, I am sleeping, he must have discovered. Nishada aga. Tamapi ashu saha lulava. Means, he shook off that sleep also he shook off. Then what happens? Nidra gone, so gone. Now, one thing, don't make a content of this. Achha, this happens first, that after that. This happened in this case. In other case, 100 things can happen. It depends. So, it's just a sample of Vithana Samskara. Tasya Nidra Vyapagami. When he got rid of that sleep, and the sleep went away, means got rid of sleep. Yomavat. Yoma samvit samudhyayau. Samudhyayau he perceived. What did he perceive? Yoma samvit, space awareness. He was aware of the space. So he was aware of the cognizance. He was aware of it. Yoma samvit nisha. When he created the awareness, it was destroyed. Asya nasyana mudham bhavat. It sank in spot. Mind sank in spot. Then finally, his mind got absorbed in the Atma Swarupa.
Sarva
Tataha, thereafter means after so much of effort by in eliminating the vitthan samskara, the obstruction that was stalling the virodha samadhi, asampradnya samadhi, tataha, manaha, his mind, having got rid of all these, what are those? Free from all these, tejaha, light, tamaha, darkness, nidra, sleep, moha, stupor, adi, parivarjitam, some state, he accomplished, he got some state wherein none of these earlier obstructions were there. And what is that state? Kam api. Some state. Why that kam api? Because it is anirvachaniya. It cannot be described like this. You know what is that state? Absorption in the Atma Sarupa. How can you describe Atma Sarupa like this? So therefore, kam api. So that anirvachaniya. So kamapi avastham, kshanam asadhya, having attained for a while. Kshanam means movement here, means for a while. Vishashrama, he rested, he stopped, he reposed. No more mental images, no more vikshepa, no more stupor. No more aviveka means he could directly cognize the Atma Swarupa. Now what needs to be done to get rid of this vitthana samskaras? We should put forth such efforts which can generate the nirodha samskaras. Impressions by which what is generated is nirodha. What is nirodha? Vrittyuparama, uparama of the vritti, cessation of the vritti can be such efforts to be put forth that is now being stored. See, I hope you remember what is this discussion or elaboration. Sutra, the Nirodha Samadhi Sutra, Vyutthana Nirodha Samskara Yoho Abhibhava Pradurbhavau Nirodha Lakshana Chittonvayaha Nirodha Parinamaha. This Sutra is being explained in that context. What is Vyutthana Samskara? He gave a demonstration. So therefore, Vyutthana Samskaranam Abhibhavaha Nirodha Samskaranam Pradurbhavaha. So now that Abhibhava, overpowering of Vyutthana Samskara, by what is that effort required? He says, Te Vyutthana Samskara, how they can be overcome? They can be overcome by this. What is that? Nirodha hetuna yogi prayatnena. By the prayatna of the yogi, the dhyayi, the one who is practicing this to gain the asampradnya samadhi. By what prayatna? Nirodha hetuna. Nirodha hetuna means nirodha karana rupena yogi prayatnena. Nirodha karana rupena yogi prayatnena means by the efforts of yogi, which are the causes of nirodha samadhi. Such efforts should be put forth that which can result in nirodha samadhi, asampradnyata samadhi. Therefore, yogi prayatnena. Pratidinam pratikshanam cha abhibhuyanti. Every day every movement. What does it mean? This alone must be the only preoccupation, nothing else. Pratikshamcha abhibhuyante are overpowered, are terminated. Tad virodhinascha. Tad virodhinascha means the vitthana samskara virodhinascha. As a result, what happens? Tad virodhi. Tad stands for vitthana samskara. So the nirodha samskaraha pradurbhavanti. The impressions which give the nirodha samadhi, they manifest, and they are opposed to what? Vyutthana samskara. So therefore, by such efforts, what happens? Vyutthana samskaras are overpowered and nirodha samskaras are generated, they manifest. So this viha, in that original sutra, nirodha lakshana is there, not nirodha kshana chitta. In the Ramakrishna Mission book, nirodha kshana is there. It is as per Andashram book, nirodha lakshana means chitta characterized by nirodha means vritti uparama. So that state, moment by moment, it's successively, it grows by due efforts. Tathasati nirodhaha ekaike. Tathasati means when it happens so. What happens so? Vitthana samskaras are subdued and nirodha samskaras are manifest. When this such so it happens, nirodhaha means that the asampradnyat samadhi, the state wherein all the vrittis are eliminated. Ekaikasmin kshane chittam anugacchati. Anugacchati means accompanies. Chittam anugacchati means it accompanies the antakarana. Mind means movement by movement, what happens? These vritti uparama, teta means gets manifest in the mind. The result of such a chitta means wherein movement by movement what is manifest? Vrittyuparama. Nirodha means vrittyuparama. Cessation of the vritti. So that is generated, means the result of that is nirodha samadhi or asampradnyata samadhi. That is what he says. So soyamha chitta means saha ayam idrishaha chittasya nirodha parinamaha. Means that means this type of state of the mind is in the form of what? Nirodha samadhi. Nirodha parinama, this word is from the sutra. Bhavati, that is so. Means what happened now? Nirodha samadhi has taken place. Nirodha samadhi has taken place means what? Total vrittyuparama, total cessation of vritti has taken place. When vrittis are totally absent, is there any change? Everything is what? As it is. A doubt. We don't know, but that fellow knows. See, don't think all Purapakshis are stupid. they are, at times they may. Actually, it is to make the things clear. See, you are telling all vrittis have stopped. When all vrittis have stopped, what happens? It's something like stand still. But the rule is, except Chaitanya, anything and everything in the creation changes moment by moment. There is always a flux of change, movement by movement, except Chaitanya. Chaitanya is not subject to any vikara, not subject to parinama. And you are talking of the chitta, wherein vrittis are not there. Vrittis are not there means everything is still. So how is it possible? My dear sir, you are right. You are right, but we will point out there is some change is there, but not what and that change is a beneficial change, and it is not something which can create samskara or samsara, or which can create problem or obstructions. Purapaksha. See, this doubt is there. Look, that is, it is in quotation. Chiti shakte he rute bhavaha hi pratikshana parinaminaha iti nayena. Nyaya means rule. By this rule, what is that? Chiti shakte he rute. Rute means vina, except for. Without the chiti shakti. Chiti shakti means chaitanya, pure awareness principle, pure consciousness principle, chaitanya tattva. Except chaitanya tattva, bhavaha, all the things without any exception, all the things means all the things where? In the creation. In the creation, all the things in the creation without any exception, he says, pratikshana parinaminaha, change, transform, moment by moment. So, iti nyayena, by this rule. Now tell me, you are talking of vritti uparama, for whom? Chitta. Now this rule applies to chitta also. How is it possible that a chitta can continue to exist if chitta is destroyed? That's fine. But how can chitta continue to exist without this viparinama? How is it parinama? How is it possible? He says, iti nyayena, by this rule, chittasya sarvada parinama pravaha vaktavyaha. You should also tell, means you should also accept the parinama pravaha, the flux of change in the case of chitta always. And we are talking of vritti uparama, means no parinama, no change. So how is it? The answer is, badham. Yes. What you said is correct. What does it mean? Vedanti also accepts there must be parinama in the chitta. When? Even in the state of nirodha samadhi. Even the state of nirodha samadhi, asampradnya samadhi, yes. But how we don't find? Yes, we don't find now this. So he explains now. Tatra means among these two things now. A chitta which is in the state of nirodha samadhi and the chitta which is not in the state of nirodha samadhi. So therefore the chitta which is not in the state of nirodha samadhi is vithita chitta. Vithita means which is out of the nirodha samadhi. Other one is nirodha samadhi. Now, in the chitta, the mind which is not in nirodha samadhi, the chitta vritti pravaha is very evident. That he says. See, look here. Tatra, among these two. What are those two? The chitta in nirodha samadhi and outside the purview of nirodha samadhi. He says, vithita chitta sa vritti pravaha sputaha. Sputa means evident. Clear. What is clear? The vritti pravaha, the flow of thoughts in the case of the mind which is not in the state of nirodha samadhi is very evident. So therefore what? Your rule applies. Your rule means, yes, it is a rule. It is accepted rule. Applies. Now what is there? In nirodha samadhi also pravaha is there. You can't say vritti pravaha. Why? Vrittis are absent. And at the same time you are accepting. So that needs to be pointed out. So we have to prove there is parinama even in the nirodha samadhi. What type of parinama it is needs to be described. So therefore it says, तथा निरुद्ध चित्त से तो कथम इति आशंक्य। निरुद्ध चित्त से परिणाम प्रवाह द फ्लो ऑफ चेंज हाउ इज इट पॉसिबल बिकॉज वृत्ति हैव सीज्ड सो इति आशंक्य हैविंग सो हाउ इट हैपन्स इन द केस ऑफ निरुद्ध और निरोध समाधि हैविंग ओवर। उत्तरम सूत्रयति इट्स reply is being described in the subsequent sutra. What is that? Tataha samskarat prashanta vahita. Tataha, let's say, tataha, thereafter. Thereafter means what is already accomplished? Nirodha samadhi jagmeh. Alternative is there, tatra also is there. Tatra means in the Nirodha Samadhi. Tatra samskara, on account of samskaras, impressions, what is there? Prashanta vahita. There is prashanta pravaha. Vahita means pravaha. There is a pravaha, that is what prashanta means, which is not easily available for you to detect. Like vrittis, which you can easily, you see, means thereafter, by samskaras, there is a steady flow of progressive shanti. Prashanta vahita means there is a flow. What flow? The shanti in a successive progress. It is going to be explained. With the illustration, it is going to be explained. So therefore, prashanta pravaha means a pravaha, a flow of peace in a successive growth. More and more and more depending on the intensity of the samadhi, how duration, etc. is there. So depending on that, it is there. And it is in terms of what? Samskara. Samskara, what type of samskaras? Samskaras of Nirodha in the earlier kshana. Samskaras of the Nirodha in the earlier moment, which will be clear with the illustration. That is now explained. What is this? The samskara of the earlier kshana, let us see. Illustration like this. Yatha samit ajyahuti prakshepi vanni. In the fire, of course, some yajna yaga or something is there. So what is that? Samit, the dry twigs, the dry sacred twigs, not any twigs, of certain trees only as such. That's samit. Samit, ajya, the ghee, ahuti, other oblations, prakshepi. Then these are offered in the fire. What happens to the fire? Vannihi uttarottara vridhya prajvalati. The fire gets, fire burns, it is ablaze by uttarottara vridhya, means in successive growth. Why? More and more you put, more and more ablaze it is. That is what uttarottara, in a successive manner, it grows and it burns. Now, all samit is burnt. What happens to the fire? Fire gets pacified. How it gets pacified? Suddenly disappears? No. Moment by moment, the fire gets reduced and finally at calm. So that is it. समिदादिक्षये when समित आज्य उत्तरक्षणे शांति शांति ही वर्धते सो इन द सक्सेसिव मूवमेंट शांति हियर शांति इज नॉट पीस शांति ऑफ एक्सटिंक्शन ऑफ फायर सी वी आर टॉकिंग ऑफ द प्रज्वलन ऑफ द फायर सो शाम्यति से प्रथम क्षणे अग्नि ही किंचित शाम्यति इट गेट्स स्पेसिफाइड टू समथिंग इट गेट्स फ्लेम्स गेट रिड्यूस्ड And in the subsequent movements, one after the other, that shanti means extinction of the fire, reduction of the flame. What happens? So it goes on, vardhate, it goes on increasing. What goes on increasing? Not flame, extinction of the flame. The fire gets reduced further and further, further and further. Tatha, like that example, निरुद्ध चित्तस्य इन द केस ऑफ माइंड वेर वृत्ति उपरम द सेसेशन ऑफ वृत्ति इज अकम्प्लिश्ड से उत्तरोत्तराधिकः प्रशमः जनरली व्हाट हैपन्स उत्तरोत्तराधिकः प्रशमः सब्सिक्वेंट मीन्स मूवमेंट आफ्टर मूवमेंट सक्सेशन एज सच व्हाट हैपन्स अधिकः प्रशमः More and more cessation of the flow, that is the flow of the thoughts. So that is, what increases? The steadiness of the mind gets increased. So uttarotra adhika prashamaha pravahati flows. What flows? Look here. Earlier That reduction in the flame is the cause for subsequent reduction. Likewise, here earlier vritti uparama, its sanskaras generate the further uparama of the vritti. So therefore it is that prashama, that pacification of vritti and that continuation of nirodha samadhi, pravati is available in the flow, a flux or a flow. So therefore, how it is? Tatra purva purva prashama janitaha sanskaraha eva. The impressions janita, born of, generated by the earlier, that is pacification of the vrittis, extinction of the vritti itself is uttarottara prashamasya karanam, is the cause of the subsequent prashama. Prashama means the vritti uparama. So this is how, what happens, there is certainly a flow of sanskaras of the prashama. It goes on increasing. This itself is explained by none other than Lord Krishna in the book that you already are familiar with but never knew that these aspects are these aspects are discussed. See, many of the Gita's are generally in Bhashya also doesn't deal with that. So who? Vidyarana Muni has unearthed that. Tametam. तामेताम प्रशांतवाहिताम वाहिता इज प्रवाह द सेम प्रवाह दैट इज तामेताम इज नाउ डिस्क्राइब्ड इन द वन दैट इज डिस्क्राइब्ड नाउ इज प्रशांतवाहिता द प्रवाह ऑफ द सक्सेसिव शांति प्रशांति इन द अंतकरण इन टर्म्स ऑफ निरोध समाधि। भगवान लॉर्ड कृष्णा विस्पष्टम उदाजहार हैज साइटेड हैज डिस्क्राइब्ड विविडली इन भगवद गीता चैप्टर 6 स्टांजास 18 to 23। यदा वेन विनियतम चित्तम द चित्त विच इज विनियत मीन्स विच हैज अकम्प्लिश्ड द असंप्रज्ञात समाधि असंप्रज्ञात समाधि। सो यू मे आस्क व्हाई भाष्यकार हैज नॉट एक्सप्लेन्ड ऑल दीज थिंग्स दैट इज द जॉब ऑफ प्रकरण ग्रंथ। सो He just establishes the truth, elaborates, etc. These are the, see, why? Because this is the job of what? Ashtanga Yoga. Ashtanga, he can't. Bhashya has got certain rules. He can't go on telling anything, everything, not anything, everything as such. It needs to be handled by some other person. So they are there. Vinitam Chittam आत्मनि एव अवतिष्ठते abides in the Atma. What is this? This chittam abides in the Atma. अच्छा, the mind which was running here and there, I think got an air-conditioned room in Atma. Appa, cosy chair also is there. Let me sit here only in the running here and there in the sun and here after the vishyas, because you have to run here and there. Is it that way? Mind remaining or abiding in Atma means antakarna chitta, mind assuming the nature of Atma, being the replica of Atma, that is what? Atmakara, becoming Atmakara. Further explanation refer to Gita chapter 18 stanza 50 Bhashya bas. That is because I have taken it 100 times, that's why I am telling you that. You should know, if somebody argues too much, refer. He doesn't know Bhashya, but you can make mouth shut. So refer to Bhashya of stanza 50 of 18th chapter of Vivekananda. He can't make head or tail of it. At least you find out their Atmakara word, you find out, you tell him. Atmakara word, you find out, you tell them. What is Atmakara? Exactly, mind becoming Atmakara. Reasons also are given there. Atmaneva avatishtate remains, means it becomes Atmakara. To become Atmakara, what is necessary? You may say, that Atmakara, what it has to do with Nirodha Samadhi? In Nirodha Samadhi only it can become that. See, when Adhyastha all are removed, that is what the Asamprajnat Samadhi, that is Nirodha Samadhi, Nirvikalpa stage. See, the different words are used because these are the terminologies of Yoga Shastra, therefore the Nirodha Samadhi, Asamprajnat Samadhi. There it is not there. Nirvikalpa means kaam ho gaya udhar. That's all. Nirvikalpa said means that is what it is. It is not. Nirvikalpa is separate, Nirodha Samadhi is separate, and Asamprajnat Samadhi is separate. Not that way. These are different terminologies used for this. The Atmaneva Avatishtate, then with that you add, again add Yada, the Sarva Kamebhya Nispruha Bhavati. A mind which is absorbed in the Atma Sarupa, what it will desire? What it will desire? Nothing. Because Paramananda Sarupa already directly discovered. So therefore, Sarva Kamebhya Nispruha Bhavati. No hankering for here kama means vishayas. No hankering for any vishayas whatsoever, objects of the tada, then it is said to be yuktaha iti uchyate. It is said to be yukta, and for which you will find the verb bhashya samahita. And what is samahita? Samadhistha. Yuktaha means samahita, and samahita means samadhistha. And what is that samadhistha? Because atmani eva natu visayeshu natu adhyasteshu. So therefore it is what? It is asampradnyata samadhi. It is nirodha samadhi. Yuktaha iti ucchate. Now, to this state of chitta, when it abides in the atma swarupa, which otherwise called as nirodha samadhi or asampradnyata samadhi, an illustration is given by Lord Krishna. That yogi is yata chittasya. So one who is, mind is absorbed in the atma swarupa, in the nirodha samadhi, that state of mind is compared to a lamp. What lamp it is? Yatha nivatasthaha deepaha. Just as a lamp. This lamp, oil lamp, or let us say candle, etc., not other electric lamps as such, where flame is there. A lamp where flame is there. And nowadays even electric lamps, flames are, they make that little flickering. That flickering. That will not work. Do you know why? It flickers. Even though it is in a glass, this thing, it flickers. You may say it is nivatastha, but it is not the flame as such. So that is different. So here, the actual oil flame, this lamp flame. So nivatastaha means a lamp which is placed in a place where there is no even breeze, not even a whiff of breeze is there. Nivatasa deepaha. What is it? Na ingate, na chalati. It doesn't move. It is very, very steady. It doesn't move. Sa upama, that illustration is given to the mind of the yogi who has accomplished this atmani avasthanam, this asampradnyata samadhi, nirodha samadhi. Sa upama, this is his word, atmanaha yogam yunjataha yoginaha yata chittasya smrita. Smrita means considered. That illustration is considered for whom? For the one yogi, the mind of the one. Atmanaha yogam yunjataha. Atmanaha, of mind. Yogam means absorption, samadhi. Yunjataha, the one who is practicing. Who is that? Yoginaha. Yoginaha. Yata chittasya means sanyata antakaranasya. Yata chittasya is sanyata antakaranasya. What is that sanyata antakaranasya? That which is absorbed in the swarupa. This is nirodha samadhi which has accomplished. Smrita, consider. Atmanaha is of the mind. Yogam means absorption, or that samadhi. Yunjataha means the person who is practicing samadhi to get the mind absorbed in this, and he has accomplished that samadhi. So for that, this upama is considered, is given. Further, that state is being described. See, these stanzas have got other aspects also, but we are focusing on those aspects related to Nirodha Samadhi. Otherwise, Bhasha describes many things as such. And this is not Bhagavad Gita class. This text is Jivan Mukti. Like, If each and every stanza's quotation given were to be explained from ABCD onward, it will take 10 years to complete Jivan Mukti, because it is nothing but such quotations only as such. Yatra means when. Yoga Sevaya, by practice of Samadhi. And Samadhi here is what? Nirodha Samadhi, Asampradnyata Samadhi. Practice of Samadhi. Niruddham Chittam. The mind, which is Niruddha, means Sarvataha Nivarita Pracharam. Means the mind which is warded off from all mentations, all vrittis are totally controlled, terminated. Niruddham Chittam Uparamate, totally withdraws from all mentations. Uparamate, totally withdrawn from all mentations, means functions of the chitta, the mind. Again, yatra, cha, when, atmana, atmanam. So, atmana, what is that atmana? Antakkaranena. But what antakkarana? Samadhi parishuddhena antakkaranena. Make a note, this is from Bhashya. Don't think samadhi is something that somebody has told something. Shankaracharya has told this. Samadhi parishuddhena antakkaranena. That is what is called as atmana. This is from Bhashya. Means, Shankaracharya has not elaborated, has simply referred to this Nirodha Samadhi. Why? It is the job of the, once hint is given that it is Asampradnyat Samadhi, one can find it out from where? From the Yoga Sutra. So that is where it is. So that means that is the Bhashyakara cannot dwell there, because that is, he will be making something elaborate, etc., and the main purpose will not be served. Atmana, atmana means samadhi parishuddhena antakkaranena, by the antakkarana, which is now pure because of accomplishing of the nirodha samadhi. Atmanam pashyan. Atmanam pashyan. So that is, what is that atmanam? Param chaitanyam. The param, the limitless chaitanya swarupa atma. What is that pashyan? Atmanam param chaitanya. Pashyan means bhashya. Upalabhamanaha. Upalabhamanaha means experiencing. This word from bhashya only. Upalabhamanaha. The one who has obtained it, one who is experiencing that, pashyan atmani tushyati, is tushyati, is contented, delighted where? In atma. Otherwise, where contentment or delight is found? Vishayas. No, atmani tushyati. So this is what? Why? All because mind is totally absorbed in the Atsurupa. Vritti pravaha is not there. And with the earlier pravaha of the earlier samskaras, further and further in-depth of the experience continues. Now, what it is like? See, what is there? So, this is the experience. Pashyati. What pashyati? So, can we also pashyati? Yes. But all these efforts are necessary. So what he sees, continues.
Sukham atyantika yatkadu buddhi vrayam atindriyam veti yatrana chayvayam vipas chalati tatvataha.
So yattat atyantikam sukham buddhi grahyam atindriyam veti. Yattat, whatever that is, atyantikam sukham. You know what sukha it is? Endless sukha. आत्यंतिक अनसरपास्ड अनएक्सेल्ड एंडलेस सुख परमानंद लिमिटलेस एंडलेस मीन लिमिटलेस आत्यंतिक सुखम अगेन विच इज बुद्धिग्राह्यम विच कैन बी ग्रास्प्ड विच कैन बी एक्सपीरियंस बाय बुद्धि मीन्स वॉट एवरीथिंग इज बुद्धिग्राह्य ओनली इज इट नॉट नाउ यू आर लिसनिंग You do, if you want to demonstrate, do next class, keep the buddhi in the room and come here. Keep the buddhi in the room and come here. Everything is there. Even after lunch time, what we eat also with buddhi. Other things are there. But then, no doubt, buddhi grahya, but indriya sapeksha. Finally, experience is through the instrumentation of buddhi means antakkarana. Buddhi means antakarana, not simply intellect as such. Antakarana. But now suppose you are eating a sweet, tongue must be there, hand must be there to put. Even if hands are not there, like, no, somebody can put like a dog, you can do that. It's possible. So that is there. But tongue must be there or not. Indriya sapeksha. It depends on the indriya. Here buddhi graha means indriya nirapekshaya buddhya eva grihyate. Which is experience. What type of buddhi? Indriya nirapekshaya buddhya. A buddhi which is independent of the indriya. By that only it is gained. Indriyas have no job here because they cannot do anything whatsoever. It is not their vishaya at all. Buddhi grahyam. How do you say buddhi grahyam? The reason is given. Ati indriyam. It is beyond the purview of indriyas, ati indriyam. Veti, again, et veti, bhashyakara gives the meaning, so he says knows, not knows, anubhavati. See, bhashyakara has given the meaning as experiences. Because what is remaining is what? Anubhava swarupa, atma. And you say atma is anubhava swarupa, but no experience. All other visheshas are removed. All other visheshas, because asampradnyata, nirodh samadhi. See, look, when vritti uparama has taken place, come on, what vishesha, specific feature can you experience in terms of shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandha, or memories? Can you? Because all have to be presented through the medium of vrittis. Gone. What remains? Parishishta. Earlier the word has come parishishta. What is parishishta? Atma. You say anubhava sastat. That is what Bhashyakara says. Veti knows means anubhavati. A direct cognition. Cognition. Again, yatra, wherein, cha. Yatra, cha, sthitaha. What is sthitaha? Atma swarupe sthitaha. Abiding in the Atma swarupa. I am means this yogi, tadhyayi, what is it? Tatvataha. Tatvataha means tatva swarupa. From the swarupa of one's own true nature, Atma swarupa. Tatvataha. Na eva. Not at all. Chalati. Naeva chalati means not at all dislodged. Not at all thrown away. Means the mind, it totally gets absorbed in the swarupa. Again, what is this gain now? Let us see. Yam labdhva, yam means yam atmalabham, having got which atmaswarupa, aparam labham, any other gain, having gained the atmaswarupa, any other gain, tataha, than that atmalabha, adhikam na manyate, doesn't consider to be superior. So no gains are superior to this Atmalabha, because how do you judge the value of any accomplishment? In terms of ananda and dukkha nivritti. So here total dukkha nivritti and total ananda avapti. So therefore, so adhikam na manyate doesn't consider to be more than this. Yasmin sthitaha, yasmin atmatatve, in which atmatatve sthitaha, abiding, having got absorbed, guruna api dukkhena na vichalyate. So he is na vichalyate, not disturbed, not agitated by guruna api dukkhena, by even great sorrow. You know what Bhashyakara says, what is that great sorrow? Shastra nipatadi lakshanena. Even struck by a weapon, how much? Even if a needle pricks, you will say, hi. Now say, even struck by a weapon, how much pain, etc. was there? Not disturbed. Is it possible without just experience of the Atma Swarupa? Simply Atma is a Sachidananda Swarupa. And what continues? What Anubhava continues? good old Anubhavas continue. Good old Samsara Anubhava continues. And Atma is Ananda Swarupa. Is it possible? Guruna api dukkhena na vichalyate. See, this example is of Sadashiva Brahmendra. You know that Sadashiva Brahmendra, he was like, for external world, he was like a mad person only as such. No, even no clothes on the body, and in fact, somebody reported to his guru, your Shishya has become mad. He said, I wish I had that madness. Because guru knew instead, I wish I had that madness. So he was so absurd. Once he was going, some nawab or somebody, that is, he had pitched a tent and his all harem was there, etc. He was impervious, everything. He walked through the harem and no clothes on the. That fellow got so annoyed, he went behind that with a sword, he cut his arm. It was hanging. He was not aware and he just went at it. Then this person is not an ordinary person. And he went behind him just to apologize that and beg his pardon. He is impervious of this person. And 2-3 days he is after that, and afterwards, and he was not talking. He was, if at all something, he was writing as such. So he said, what are those? So please pardon. Why? Pardon means you should have done some offense. Then he said, I have cut. Then he said, oh. That's what, he had that power, yoga power. He just put it. So he blessed him and went away. Think of it. This is not cock and bull story, okay? Huh? This has happened. So these are come from generation, this has come, and his samadhi is there, and he's not a very old this thing. Just 1 or 2 centuries. Oh, this thing is there. Na guruna api. Why? He was buried under, see, he was in that Kaveri or something, not Kaveri. Anyway, that river. South of Madurai. What is that? Near Madurai that river flows? Huh? Vaiga, something else, some other. Anyway, that area only. So, he was lost in Samadhi. Sudden, there is that the area where sudden flood comes. Sudden flood came and he got carried away. And with that, no mud, etc. comes, no? And in the field, he got buried under this place. And afterward, the government people, they make the thing clear, etc. When the clearing, when somebody hammered it, blood came. So then that officer was there, he said, alerted, etc. And slowly they separated that and then found the body. Ut gaya. He started walking, but he was known. They knew it. Who he was, that his stature was. Yeah. गुरुना अपि न विचारते. दिस इज नॉट बदने काई पुराण, यू नो, दिस इज ओनली इन द पुराणास ओनली इट इज देयर एटसेट्रा. दिस इज द प्रैक्टिकल थिंग. बट सच महात्मा आर वेरी रेयर, बट दे आर नॉट देयर. दे गिव द प्रूफ. दिस इज व्हाट इज द थिंग. So therefore he says, guruna api na vichalyate. And that is what is called as the yoga, where the highest accomplishment is, that is gain. Tam vidya dukkha sanyoga viyogam yoga saucitam saha nischayena yoktavyaha yogo anirvinna chidva. That is the yoga, and with firm resolve, one should practice and accomplish that yoga. We'll see. Om Swasti Prajabhya Paripalayan Nyayena Margena Mahimahishaha Mahimhya Shubhamastu Nityam Loka Samasta Sukhino Bhavantu. काले वर्षतु पर्जन्य पृथिवी सस्यशालिनी सोऽयं क्षोभरहितः ब्राह्मणाः सन्तु निर्भयाः सर्वे भवन्तु सुखिनः सर्वे सन्तु निरामयाः भद्राणि पश्यन्तु मा कश्चित् दुःखभाग् असतो मा सद्गमय तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमय धृत्योर्मा अन्तर्यामि.